I'm here to tell you a story about the narrow gauge engines on the island of Sodor.
Big Fatty, you're in the wrong part.
Am I?
Yes, what? This is my part.
Oh, my mistake.
Let's go again.
Okay, I've got a break.
Anyway, I'm here to tell you a story about the narrow gauge engines on the island of Sodor. What happened to them one day? Please listen. Watch.
There are many narrow gauge engines on the island of Sodor. There are also three mountain engines, Godric, Lord Harry and Coldy. They can run on the narrow gauge if it is fairly level. At the end of every day, the engines will meet up at the sheds and listen to a story by Duke. Duke is an old engine, one of the oldest on the narrow gauge railway, and he tells great stories. All the engines will listen with great anxiety to what he has to say.
"So what's our story going to be today?"
said Scarlowy.
"I think I... No, I've just been watching too much Doctor Who. Would you like to hear a Doctor Who story?"
said Duke.
"Come on, let me know."
Bertram tooted.
Bertram looks just like Duke, except for his dark green colour.
Come on, said Sir Handel. "I want to hear a story."
Sir Handel is an impatient blue engine.
"Give him a bit of time,"
Duncan tooted. Duncan is a small engine. He is impatient and can cause a lot of accidents.
"Ah, I think I've got one,"
Duke said.
"Have I ever told you about the time when our railway closed?"
"Yes, you did,"
peeped Peter Sam.
"We were there,"
tooted Sir Handel.
"Ah, but it's a good story. Tell us it again, please,"
tooted Duncan.
"Well, if you insist,"
tooted Duke, and all the engines went quiet as Duke told his story. It was like this every night at the end of every day. The engines loved Duke's stories, but one day, it changed. A new diesel arrived on the island. Just like Diesel 10, but he was on the narrow gauge. "This is a lovely island," he purred to himself. "I can't wait to meet the narrow gauge engines." Meanwhile, Rusty, Scarlowy and Reneus were waiting at the sheds before they went off to their next job. "So bored," puffed Reneus.
"Thanks, Jock."
"What shall we do?"
tooted Rusty.
"Not got a clue,"
tooted Scarlowy.
"What can we do to entertain ourselves?"
"Not a clue," puffed Reneus.
"Listen, can you hear something?"
"Only the sound of my boredom." toot. Sounded marvelous, like a diesel engine, if you ask me, tooted Rusty. A diesel engine, but there's only you and Frank, and Frank's on the other side of the island. No, you're playing tricks on me. I'm not. Said Rusty, I can hear a diesel engine. Stop tricking us. Stop it. You're playing with our minds. Tooted Scott. Just then, Diesel 9 pulled up. Hello there. He sneered. I'm Diesel 9. And I've come here to work on your railway. Oh! Cried Vinaeus and backed into the shed. Yikes! Cried Scarlery. Rusty didn't back into the shed. Diesel 9, you sound a lot like Diesel 6. Yes, I know that. Said Diesel 9. But don't worry, I'm not like my evil brother at all. I'm well behaved. All the same, said Rusty, I'm not sure whether I should believe you or not. Well, give me a chance at least, sneered Diesel 9. Well, we do ask to give chances. Well, thank you, sneered Diesel 9 again. Scarlery hurried back out of the shed. So, you're related to Diesel 10, said Scarlery. Yes, I am, replied Diesel 9. But I'm not like him at all. All the same, I still think you're pretty suspicious. Everybody says that, said Diesel 9. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to go and get some work. But first, I'd better go and fill up with fuel. See you later. You're really lovely engines. Something's not quite right about him, said Vinaeus. I know what you mean, said Scarlery. We must keep our eye on him, said Rusty. Totally agreed, said Vinaeus. But right now, I'm going to go to work. See you later. And Vinaeus boarded onto the turntable. I think I might pass him on the way to the transfer yard with my train. I'll see what he's doing. If not, see you later. And don't forget to keep your eye on him. We won't, said Rusty. See you later, puffed Scarlery. Vinaeus hurried away. Thomas was waiting at the transfer yard for Vinaeus. He whistled when he saw him coming.
Sorry I'm late, said Vinaeus. There's a bit of trouble at the shed. We've got a new engine.
A new engine? What's he called?
Asked Thomas. He's called Diesel 9.
Diesel 9? That sounds a lot like...
Diesel 10, I know, puffed Vinaeus. He says he's related to Diesel 10. His brother, I think.
I wouldn't trust him. Anyone related to Diesel 10...
Shouldn't be trusted, I know, said Vinaeus. Rusty said the very same thing this morning. I think something might be going on.
I hope you find out what's going on. I don't want you all in any trouble.
Puffed Thomas to his friend. Same here, said Vinaeus. I do think that something
happening.
Ooh, my wheels feel wobbly. Almost like Diesel 10's returning.
Thomas shivered. Yes, said Vanessa, I know what you mean. Ugh.
Well, let me know what happens. I'd hate anything to happen to you.
Will do, tooted Vanessa, and he hurried away. Meanwhile, at the yard, Duncan was shunting gunpowder trucks.
I really like this job. If I make a vital accident, then the trucks will explode, destroying these sidings. Then they will have to close for repairs, and I'll have to rest all day long.
Duncan whistled. He was having a great time. Then, across the yard, he saw Diesel 9 pull in. Hello there, sneered Diesel 9. Nice to meet you. I'm a new engine who arrived on the Sodor Narrow Gauge Railway earlier to... Coming, said Diesel 9. Oh, what excellent work he does, Diesel 9. He's so clever and sneaky. And soon we will have the narrow gauge engines destroyed and dominated. Just as long as he keeps to the plan. One false move, Diesel 9, and you're scrapped. Get them with Pinchy. They will be destroyed. And the railway will be ours. Meanwhile, down the line, Diesel 9 was on his way to pick up a train of coal trucks. He met Elizabeth, Isabella, Jack and Alfie at a crossing. Well, hello! You must be the new Diesel everyone's talking about, tooted Elizabeth. That's me, Diesel 9. Nice to meet you, Diesel 9! Cried Jack. He raised his bucket. I'm Jack! And I'm Alfie! Laughed Alfie happily. Nice to meet you, I'm sure you'll have a great time here. Thank you very much, said Diesel 9 in his sly voice. It's nice to be here. I'll let you cross first. Well, thank you, Diesel 9, tooted Elizabeth. I'll just have to get my engine into gear first. I have all the time to wait, responded Diesel 9. Got to go and pick up some coal trucks. Come on, tooted Isabella. Let's get going. I want to get there on time. Oh, one moment, responded Elizabeth. See you later, Diesel 9. And Elizabeth hurried away. Bye! See you, tooted Jack. Sometime soon, I hope. Bye-bye, cried Alfie. Aren't they very nice? Diesel 9 said to himself. They're all good friends here. But if they knew what I had in plan... And he hurried away. Soon Diesel 9 had collected his coal trucks and arrived at the transfer yard.
Right, now where is he? Said Diesel 9, waiting. He should be here by now. Diesel 10 pulled up.
So, what's going on, Diesel 9? Apart from you're doing an excellent job.
Thank you.
Soon the railway will be ours, but I think they're getting suspicious, Diesel 10.
They might be onto us.
We'll make sure they're not. If they catch onto us and figure out what we're doing, I'll send you back to Barry's scrapyard, and you don't like it there, do you?
No, no way. Not at all. It's the most horrid place ever.
Then, just remember to do as I say.
After all, you are my brother.
And you've always wanted to take over a railway, replace all the steamies. So behave!
Sure, whatever.
I will. Anyway, I've got to get back to hiding before another steamy comes along. Thomas almost caught me earlier.
Well, you're being a bit careless. Remember what I said, Diesel 9. You don't want to get me cross, otherwise Pinchy will get you.
Sure, whatever. I think I hear Diesel. I think I hear a steamy coming. I better go. See you later, and remember not to blow the cover.
Sure, whatever.
Our plan's soon gonna be complete. I mustn't soften up. Not even for my new friends. Now this steam is... Oh, we'll get them. And then the railway will be ours to keep forever.
Just then, Thomas puffed up.
Oh, hello. You must be Diesel 9, the new engine. Related to Diesel 10, who I'd swear I saw around here earlier.
Yes, I am, replied Diesel 9. And I don't think Diesel 10 is around here. He was sent packing.
Anyway, weren't you in America visiting some guy called...
Oh, I don't know, you found with cocaine or something.
Oh, you're Marcus from the Freak Trains. I remember him.
Yeah, well, apparently it's a series on YouTube. Pretty cool, apparently, Diesel 9 said. But I hope you had a good time out there.
Okay, I don't want to be nasty or anything, but some of us engines...
Thomas began, but then was interrupted by Diesel 9. Don't think I'm to be trusted. Yes, I know, some of the narrow gauge engines have already said that because I'm related to Diesel 10. But don't worry, I'm 100% trustworthy.
Well, I suppose. You seem nice enough.
Thank you, replied Diesel 9. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to go back to the shed and rest. I'm exhausted, and Diesel 9 hurried away.
See you later. He's a bit suspicious. Ah, well, I can trust him,
said Thomas. And with that, he hurried away back to his yard.
Diesel 9 made his way to the sheds. And when he was there, he got a big surprise. What's going on here, he asked. The sheds are empty. Usually they would all be full, wouldn't they? Well, said Rusty, we felt a bit bad about, you know, not trusting you. So we've decided to give you the shed to yourself tonight as an apology. Not to get away from you or anything. Yeah, said Jock. We like you. We hope you will, you know, Oh, I don't know what to say. Oh, don't try, said you. Oh, don't say my voice has gone again. Oh, jeez, my voice keeps going. Why can't my voice? I do the same voice every time. He probably forgets, said Jock. Hey, hold on a second. They're insulting me. I'll get them later. Anyway, back to the story. Oh, that's very nice of you, said Diesel 9. But I can't stay here on my own. Some of you stay here with me. Keep me company. We'll talk through the night. That sounds like a very good idea, said Godred. I'll stay here with you. I've got my nighttime train to do, said Lord Harry. I might come back here later, though. I'd be glad to stay here with you, Diesel 9, said Colby. I'm going to sleep at the yard. I'm going to make sure the trucks are underway. Don't you mean under control, said Bertram. Maybe. Yeah, well, I've got to do the mail train tonight, so I'll be up all night and I'll be like, tomorrow. I'll stay here with you. That leaves us a couple of spaces in the sidings. I'll let someone else stay here with you. I'll stay with Rusty. We're good friends. We like to spend good time together. I'll stay here. Then I'll get to hear one of Duke's stories. I'm with you there, Duncan. I'll stay here and listen to Duke's story. Then I'll go off to the yard. I know. We'll all stay here, listen to one of Duke's stories, then go back to the yard or stay here and sleep for the night, said Scarlet. That sounds like a very good idea, said Diesel 9. I'd love to hear one of Duke's famous stories.
How'd you know they're famous?
Said Duke. Lucky guess, said Diesel 9.
Oh, good guess, said Duke. Well, you're the first one to call my stories famous. Thanks for that compliment, I think.
Yeah, well, whatever, said Duke. I'm getting tired. Let's get this story underway, then I can get to sleep as soon as possible. Man, I'm bushed. I've had a long day, traveling here across the sea, doing work and all that. Diesel 9 backed into his shed. This is going to be a lovely. This shed looks absolutely cozy. Oh, it's wonderful. I could get used to staying here. Come on, Duke, tell one of your stories, cried the mountain engines. The sooner we get it underway, the sooner we can get to sleep, because we're ready for a busy day tomorrow. Nighttime fell on the island. The engines soon fell asleep after listening to Duke's story. All of them, except for Diesel 9. Steam is, he huffed. They're not so bad after all. But they're still not as good as Diesel's. I can get them with my brother, he huffed. Oh, not long now, and the time will be right. I'd better be careful not to wake the engines up. Better get going, my brother will be wanting to meet me. If I'm not careful, I might get scrapped or caught or something or other. I don't want to be caught and destroyed by Pinchy. That'd be terrible. Oh, I better get going now. Diesel 9 purred onto the turntable quietly. said to himself, I'll be okay. I don't want to be. I've already said that. Time to go. Ooh. Said Godred's rear face. That's not good. I'll have to warn the engines. But I'd better get some sleep first.
I'm absolutely bullshit.
Diesel 9 and Diesel 10 arrived at the transfer yard. It's nearly time, said Diesel 9. Yes, and when it is time, they will all be destroyed. Laughed Diesel 10. When shall I bring them here for their domination? Asked Diesel 9. Well, I'd say bring them later this morning, and then Pinchy can destroy them. And my Pinchy too. Bring them here later today, and then we can destroy them. Make sure you block off their exit around the corner. Park them in the sidings or something, just make sure they don't escape. I need to get back to my hideout. Don't blow it, Diesel 9, or you'll find yourself back in the scrapyard. See you later, Diesel 10 hurried away. Our plan's going perfectly. Diesel 9 shuffled away.
See you later, Sandal. See ya. Oh, where is everybody? Is it going to be late? Oh no, here comes Bertram. About time. Hello, Bertram.
Hello, Sir Handel. Excited, are you? Oops, sorry about that. I wonder why we're here. Do you?
Well, apparently there's some announcement to be made, and next time be careful when you're backing down. That hurt. Anyway, we're the only ones here at the moment.
Ah, there's two.
Hello, people! I'm here! Oh, I can't wait.
Hello, everybody.
Hey, Duncan!
Are we the only ones here?
Yes!
No, there's Mustang.
Hello, everybody. Can't wait to see what all this is about.
There is an announcement to be made. What was that?
That was me, you silly engine.
And me!
More and more engines were gathering at the yard. Soon all of them would be there, crinkled up. Hello, people! I'm not tired today.
Look! Here comes Jock!
Hey everyone, why have we been called?
There is an announcement to be made.
Hurry! Bertram, Jock, and everyone else, how goes it? Ouch! Hey!
Sorry. Elf!
Ooh! Oops, sorry about that, guys.
It's just Peter Sam. Oh, he's right here.
Hey everyone, I can't wait for this announcement. What do you think it's about?
Maybe there's some new engines.
Or maybe I won an award. After all, I am special.
Not that special. Anyway, it could be about me.
No, me! I could be getting a fresh coat of paint.
Now it's gonna be me, I'm gonna get an award for sleeping so much.
No, it's gonna be for me for being such a kind engine, whatever it is anyway.
Perhaps I'm getting my own line, or a special job.
You get your own line, it's gonna be me who's getting my own line, not you. And I'm gonna have a fresh coat of paint.
No, he's gonna award me for being so wise and clever.
No, he's gonna be for us for being so fast.
So many not possibilities. Well, we'll find out soon enough. Hey Diesel, what's up?
You are. Now listen, everybody. You won't believe what I'm going to say, because I'm going to scrap you all! Yeah. Yeah, good joke.
I hope it's a joke. This would be scary if it wasn't.
Haha, good joke. Now what do you really mean?
Nothing silly. He's got to be! I mean, he's on our side!
It's no joke.
Ah! I want to get out of here!
OMG! It's too late! It was a thing!
Good work, Diesel 9. Time for me to strike, I think. Peekaboo, engines!
Oh no, this is fake. It's Diesel 10!
Excellent work, Diesel 9. Now, we'll take this little green purple first. Yes.
Why me first?
Just shut up and take like an engine would. And now, to scrap you all. One by one, each in turn, and then you will all be put into the smelting pot. Yes, ready to make new diesels which will take over the railway. So don't try to escape. There's nowhere for you to run. We'll just catch you.
I must stay here. I'm escaping. Hey! No! Ouch! Oh! Who left this all here?
Obviously, it was Diesel's part. He didn't want us to escape. I'm scared. I don't want to die.
I'm scared, I don't want to die.
Well, this could be goodbye to my friends. Last words to say.
Somebody help us!
No one will help us. Oh dear. It's dear. Diesel 10. And he's threatening that he can never engage engines. And Diesel 9. I know something creepy about him. Oh dear. I can't let my friends get scrapped. I like them too much. They're really good people. Engines, friends. Okie dokie. I think I've had enough time playing about for you. Any last words, Peter Sam, before you die?
I don't like me!
You're a train, you don't have a mother. Get it. Okay, here goes. Take this! You don't scrap my friends! It's Thomas. What are you doing here? Oh, no, it's a good thing you are here. Actually, time for me to get my revenge on you.
I can't quite reach. Come on, you can get him. And I'll get you, actually. I didn't actually think of that. Well, how can you get me if I do this? Ha ha ha! No, nuts. Well, there's still no way that you can stop me from taking these engines. Wanna try and get past me? Give it your best shot, you'll never succeed. Oh yeah? Just watch it! Come on, engines, help, push! All together! No! Come on, Peter Sam, you can do it! You can't get past me. My claw is too strong and vicious. You'll never do it. You're just worthless pieces of scrap. Right, that's it. I've had enough of this. I will show you we're not useless pieces of scrap. Yo, Peter Sam! Right. Must be brave. Ah! Ow, balls. I did it. Well done, Peter Sam! Woohoo! We're all free! Yeah! Freedom! Woohoo! Freedom! We're free! Woohoo! Well done, Peter Sam! Hey! Let's get out of here while we still can! See you later, Scholarly, my nose. Hooray! See ya, Bertram! Woohoo!
Yay! Freedom!
Hey! I'm out of here! So am I! Well, now then, what shall I do with you two? I think I have a perfect idea. You're gonna let us go and pretend that this never happened?
Yeah, or just give us another chance, please, or I'll scrap you!
The idea which I have is a summoned lady.
Oh, hello.
I was wondering when you two would show up again. Now, we didn't do anything. I've been watching you. Not really, but I know what's happened. I can read your mind. I'm special. I think I know just what to do with you.
You're gonna let us go? Yeah? Please, I'll never be mean again. I promise.
Oh, no, I don't fall for that trick, Dan. Well, I think I'm going to send you away! There we go. All nicely done.
Wow.
Well done, lady. Yes. Now, Thomas, I must go. I am needed back in my home. I shall see you soon.
Oh, she is so hot.
Oh, I love that lady.
Yeah, she is quite an engine, isn't she?
Oh, see you later, Duke. Glad she put you back on the line. Well, I'm out of here. Nothing more from me. The story soon spread across Sodor, and the Fat Controller told the story to everyone. He even made a stage show about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I will tell you a frightening story about narrow gauge engines here on Sodor, involving near-death experience. An evil diesel called Diesel Knight came to a railway with intentions to scrap all the little engines, replacing them with diesels. Follow our story now. And all the engines were glad
they are free. Well, that was quite a day.
Yes.
I'm still a bit nerve-wracking thingy. Ah, oh, it's nice to be back in the sheds, nice and free.
Oh, yes. Hey, who wants to listen to one of my stories? A freedom story!
Oh, yay! Story!
Woohoo!
And so, they are all very happy to this very day. But no one knows where Lady sent Diesel 9 and Diesel 10. Maybe we'll see them again.